So, I bet I'm blaming him right
now. I apologize. I said, sorry, I'd like to tell you I'm putting you in the shade, but I'm not.
Okay.
Lord, thank you so much for today. Thank you for this moment. Thank you. Bless this marriage and bless this ceremony. Everybody here is involved. Thank you so much. Watch over us. Keep us safe. Pray for me. Anything. This is happening. Thank you. We love you. Can't wait to see you.
David. They grow up fast, don't they?
Yeah. Of God, in the presence of friends and loved ones, celebrate one of life's greatest moments. We are here to give recognition to the worth and beauty of love, and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words that will unite Corey and Allie in sacred marriage. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Please be seated. Corey and Allie, marriage is the most important of all earthly relationships. It should be entered into reverently, thoughtfully, and with full understanding of its sacred nature. Your marriage must stand by the strength of your love and the power of faith in each other and in God. Just as two threads woven together form a beautiful tapestry, so too your lives merged together in God will make a beautiful marriage. Please bow your head in prayer. Hand in hand, Corey and Alex stand before you, O Lord. Hand in hand, they are stepping out in faith. We who are gathered here ask that you would take this couple into your hands on this special day. Help them grow in their love for one another and for you with every day that passes. Help them sense your presence now and to savor these words that I share with them. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. You know, Corey, a while back, you and I were paint partners at the church on my work day at the church, and we got to know each other pretty well that day. Little did I know I'm going to be doing your wedding a year later. It is really an honor to know both of you, to have shared a lot with you, and to do your wedding today. We've been meeting and talking about building a lasting relationship. My advice and wisdom is not done. We'll get some more today. And so I want to give those. Some of these are things we talked about. Some are a little different spin on some of the things we talked about. The first thing I'd share with you is marriage is sacred. God created the whole idea of marriage between a man and a woman. He defined it, and He is the one who is the foundation of the relationship. It's in His power and strength that your marriage will prosper and endure for a lifetime, as He intended. Secondly, God is not going to force a great marriage on you. Revelation 3:20 reads, I stand at your door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in. He brings the blessings of heaven right up to the front door, to our front door. But that's where He stops. He waits for us to decide whether we want His blessings. He gives us the freedom to choose in all phases of life, even in marriage. Marriage is about making wise choices every day of our life. And it's about choosing each other every day. Choosing each other anew tomorrow, day after, and day after affirms marriage like few other things do. And the vows you take today should not be a one-time only event. Share them with each other for the rest of your lives. Third, marriage is about commitment. Those powerful words you'll share in your wedding vows are all about commitment. You are pledging today to be committed to each other and to your marriage for the rest of your lives before a God you know is committed to you. Allow your struggles and hardships to strengthen your relationships. Strengthen it. Struggles and hardships are part of life and are sure to come. Stress-free life never is and never will be. You know that building muscles requires stress. Likewise, God allows stress in our lives to grow us. The pressure of finances and, oh yes, in-laws and other things, certainly children, relationships, and a thousand other adjustments will all play major roles in developing you as husband and wife so that you truly can become one flesh. Fifth, love each other sacrificially. Love is a complicated emotion. The Greeks used multiple words to describe different kinds of love. The three of these Greek words we talked about. We talked about romantic love, brotherly love, and sacrificial love. All three should be a part of your marriage relationship. But sacrificial love, agape love, is an absolute necessity for a marriage to endure. It is far more intentional than any other form of love. It means loving another person, even when you don't like what they're doing, even when they hurt you, offend you, disappoint you. There will be more than a few times in your relationship that you'll need to forgive one another. That forgiveness will only happen through a foundation of sacrificial love and the strength of sacrificial love. Finally, we talked about this quite a bit, turn your eyes upon Jesus every day. Your faith in Christ is the one thing that you can always have in common. The closer you draw to Him, the closer you draw to each other. Look to Him, listen to His teachings, and follow His example. When you do, you'll experience a relationship like no other. At this time, I want you to face each other. And Allie, will you please turn your palms up? I want you to turn your palms up. And Corey, you need to see him. You already know what to do. You're holding her hands, okay? So you can see her palms. Corey, these are the hands of the one who has promised to love and cherish you all the days of her life. These hands are smooth and young and carefree now, but one day will be lined and rougher because of their work in seeking to make your life more comfortable. These are the hands that will hold any children with which God blesses you in tender love, soothing them through illness and disciplining them as needed. These are the hands that will hold you, comfort you, and encourage you. These hands will hold your face and wipe your tears in wonder and awe that you would cry for her. Corey, the one whose hands you hold is to be your wife. Upon your life, your love, and your devotion, she will lean for strength and inspiration. She will look to you for encouragement, for cheerfulness, and for confidence. May your life and love be the inspiration that will constantly lead her to a greater dependence on the Lord. Allie, these are the hands, young and strong, of the one who is promising to love and cherish you all the days of your life together. These are the hands that will work long hours to earn a living for you and the family with which God blesses you. These are the hands that will be nicked and bruised for trying to fix things around the house to make you more comfortable. These are the hands that will wipe tears from your eyes, that will comfort you in illness and hold you in fear or grief assault your soul. These are the hands that will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into His eyes. Your eyes filled with love and desire for you. Allie, the one whose hands you hold is to be your husband. Upon your life, your love, and your devotion, He will lean for strength and inspiration. He will look to you for encouragement, for cheerfulness, and for confidence. May your life and love be the inspiration that will constantly lead him to greater dependence on the Lord. This time, Corey and Allie will express their love for each other and express their vows to one another. They've chosen to write their own vows.
Allie Brooks, you love my life. I love your God's goodness and provision in my life. I promise to always pursue our Lord first. I promise to love you unconditionally and without hesitation or reservation, and to never keep score. I promise to always laugh with you and never go to bed angry. promised to have patience and love demands, to speak when words are needed, to be silent when they're not. I'll do my best. I promise to intentionally pursue you every single day, take care of you, provide for you, and put all your needs before mine. I commit to remind you every single day just how smoke and hot you are, and also what a beautiful person you are. I commit to always be honest with you, to push you from here to forget, and try to be on time. I commit to communicate fully and fearlessly. I can make remember that what I was saying is different instead of wrong. I can make you regardless of situation or circumstance. I promise to hold your hand if you can't do it. I vow to cherish you for who you are today. I vow to be your safest place and protect you. I vow to use these hands to hold and commend, fix and heal, and ultimately build a life with you and use God's love and grace to benefit you. I commit to be a spiritual leader of our home. I commit to love our children even when they push my buttons like I promise what's mine is yours, except for a moat and a big bucket for home. I promise to make our house a home that honors God. And give you a word that'll make it my life's work to be here. I can't promise. I can't promise we'll never have conflict or that life will be perfect, but I can promise it will be a perfect life to live with you while pursuing our God. I believe in you, the person you will grow to be, the couple we will grow to be together. I truly am the luckiest man. I can't imagine growing old with anyone else but you. The good times for this will never end, and the hard times that seem like they never will, I will always be there. This is my final vow. You are the one that can say it as well as myself. So before God and these witnesses, I thank you to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better and for worse, sickness and in health, for richer and for poor, to love and cherish the death of this part. I will love you to the mountains of that all the days of my life.
Before you leave, the day we've been waiting for is finally here. Today is the start of our eternal relationship, and I couldn't be happier. It's amazing how God's plan works out in our lives, even without us realizing it, until we turn around to look. I have prayed for you, and I have patiently waited for you. And Corey, you are well worth the wait.
One used tissue.
I'm so thankful for the man you are and the man you strive to become. I love how supportive you are of me and how I never doubt your love for me. I love how you can make me smile and laugh better than anyone else. And that's one reason I know this will be such an adventure with you. There are many things I'm looking forward to doing with you, like experiencing life with you, making memories together, building a family with you, and seeing you as a dad. So on this day, in front of all of our family and friends, I make these promises to you. I promise to love you with my whole heart for my whole life. I promise to respect you. I promise to encourage you. I promise to be intentional. I promise to never go to bed angry and to always kiss you goodnight. I promise to pray with you and for you. I promise to love you through the peaks and the valleys that love your heart into the valley. I promise to be the best wife I know how to be. And I promise to remember that our relationship trumps every issue we will ever face. I promise to make Christ the center of our relationship daily. Thank you for loving me so well. I want to spend the rest of my life loving you. Amen.
Thank you, Corey.
That's special. That's love, folks. That's love. Corey and Allie, with love in your hearts, you have chosen to exchange rings as the sign and seal of the vows you have made today. May I have the rings? Though small in size, these rings are very large in significance. made of precious metal. They remind us that love is not cheap, nor common. Indeed, love may cost us dearly. Made in a circle, their design tells us that love must never come to an end. We must keep it continuous. As you wear these rings, whether together or apart for a moment, may they be constant reminders of these glad promises you are making today. Corey, you can do it. Repeat this promise after me, saying, with this ring, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving husband, as God is my witness. This promise, saying, with this ring, I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband. Loving wife. We gotta have something funny in the as God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
Just checking to see if you're listening. Let's pray. Our Father, we come today asking your blessing upon these two lives, their relationship, and the home they will build together. You have made us so that you are incomplete without the other, so that we yearn for someone whom we can love and whose love we can receive. We are thankful for the love we see here, and even more for the love we feel from them. May we never take your love for granted. We pray that your love will be the shield and stay for Corey and Alan. When joy comes, may they share it together. When sorrow threatens, may they bear it together. In gladness or in tears, in sunshine or shadow, may they ever draw closer to each other and nearer to you. Grant them patience, gentleness, perseverance, and understanding. Oh, Father, protect their home from those forces that would break it apart. We ask for health, for long life, for the fulfillment of every good dream. May their love continue through life and finally blend into the life eternal. Through Jesus the Christ, I pray. Amen. You have come before us and before God and have expressed your desire to be husband and wife. You have shown your love and affection by joining hands, have made promises of faith and devotion to each other, and have sealed these promises by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore pronounce you husband and wife. May God bless you and keep you and give you his peace. Amen. When God is joined together, let man not separate. Or you may kiss your bride.
When he was 17, he met the girl, the one in all his dreams, man, that was it. He never once looked back, he found something. Just knew it was gonna last. And if you ask him about that day, he'll just tap his chest and say, that's how you know. When it grabs a hold of you, you won't let go. You feel like she's always been your soul. So I walked up to her door, and I was shaking like a leaf there on her porch, till she flashed that smile at me, and such a took my breath away, and she still does to this day. Always been your soul.
You grab a hold of me and won't let go. It feels like you've always been in my soul. That's how you know.
Having a big hand for a bride and groom, Terry and Allie. This is time as Jeremiah was. We would ask Corey to please escort his mother Debbie to the dance floor for a very special groom and
Jesus, when I gave my heart to him, and he Yeah.